Good day, and welcome to Mission Control Houston, where flight controllers are watching over the International Space Station as it orbits high above the southern Indian Ocean off the southern coast of Australia and Tasmania. Emily Nelson is the flight director here on duty today, and she's got Anna Fisser, the spacecraft communicator, a veteran astronaut, by her side talking with the crew aboard the space station. Commander Mike Fossum, flight engineer Satoshi Furukawa, and Sergei Volkov are continuing through a day of activities of preparations for their departure, which is scheduled for late in November, and for the arrival of three more crew members who are getting ready to launch this Sunday from the Baikonur Cosmodrome in Kazakhstan. That'll be Dan Burbank, the future Expedition 30 commander of the space station, along with Russians Anatoly Ivanishin and Anton Shkaplerov. They're scheduled to dock with the International Space Station on the 16th of November, a Wednesday. The official launch time for their vehicle, a Soyuz TMA-22, the last of the old-style Soyuz crew vehicles, is scheduled for 10:14 p.m. Central Time on November the 13th. That'll actually be Greenwich Mean Time, which the crews operate on Monday, November the 14th. And they'll be docking on the 16th of November to the Poisk module of the International Space Station at 11:33 p.m. Central Time, which is technically November the 15th in Houston. The change of command ceremony as the Expedition 29 crew hands over to the Expedition 30 crew is scheduled for Sunday, November the 20th. And that will be Mike Fossum handing over command of the space station to Dan Burbank. This will be a relatively short handover period between the two crews, based on a delay of the launch of the Expedition 30 crew following a Progress 44 launch failure that was followed by a successful Progress 45 launch. And yesterday, the top managers of the space station program reviewed all preparations for Dan Burbank and Anton Shkaplerov and Anatoly Ivanishin's launch aboard their Soyuz spacecraft and gave a go for that launch this Sunday, which will be expanding the crew to six people for about 6 days of handovers. And then it'll be time for Mike Fossum, Satoshi Furukawa, and Sergei Volkov to return home to Earth after 6 months in orbit. They're scheduled to undock from the space station on Tuesday of November 22nd, technically the 21st of November in Houston, and then land on the steps of Kazakhstan at 8:25 p.m. Central Time, November 21, which will be 8:25 a.m. Kazakhstan time on November 22. All systems on the space station are working very well today as the crew does those preparations for departure. Coming up, they're going to be doing some sampling of the water systems that recycle the liquids aboard the International Space Station for use. And Satoshi Furukawa is going to be working with the deployment of some communications equipment for the onboard computer network, while Sergei Volkov focuses his activities on a laser communications system work. Earlier today, Commander Mike Fossum sent down some special words to voters on the ground in the United States, where it's election day, and he indicates that he's getting ready to do his voting and urges others to do so. We have a video clip of that. Let's take a look at that clip now.
And let's see, I've got just one more thing, Mike. Just a heads up, tomorrow is election day, and if you're planning any inputs, they are due before evening DPC tomorrow. Now, that's all I have for you all tonight. Do you have anything for us?
Hey, thanks for that reminder to get out and vote. I have the information, and I will be doing that tonight. Thanks. Hope everybody has a chance to, everybody else has a chance to do that too.
Well, we plan on it, and we'll be doing it along with you. So do you have anything else for us?
No, nothing else from us for Houston tonight.
Okay, well then I'll hand you over to Huntsville.
Astronauts are able to vote from the International Space Station through a special agreement that was worked out with the state of Texas. They have worked out with the appropriate county clerk offices to set up for the capability. Astronauts use a secure connection to cast their votes to the appropriate county clerk's office, either Galveston or Harris counties, depending on where they reside. And a secure electronic ballot is generated by the county clerk's office to get into that. The ability to cast a vote from space was given to astronauts through the Texas House of Representatives. And the first and was signed into law in July 9, 1997. Astronaut David Wolf was the first astronaut to vote from space when he lived aboard the Russian Mir space station in 1997. And many other astronauts have voted in elections throughout the years since then. We are receiving some downlink video as Mike Fossum works on those water sampling activities that were mentioned in the Destiny Laboratory module, and otherwise fairly routine operations aboard the International Space Station today. We did have a special event earlier today with the deputy head of the U.S. Department of Education, and we'll be replaying that event for you a little bit later in this hour. This is Mission Control Houston.